والسلام على أشرف المرسلين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. طيب, we're going to pick up from the last class. We talked about مرفوعات. Everybody remember these, right?
Yes.
And everybody's memorized them.
Yes.
Abdul-Qadir, right? Right? You can draw them out for me when I'm going to erase this, right? All right, good. I'm not going to do it, but next class, I'm going to call on anybody at random to draw this chart out. So you better know it. مرفوعات, what makes an اسم مرفوع? We talk about مرفوعات, منصوبات, مجرورات, توابع, but we're going to memorize all of these, inshallah. The first thing we talked about is المبتدأ. What is المبتدأ?
Subject.
The subject. Excellent. That, it's an اسم, it's at the beginning, usually, of a جملة. اسمية. Excellent. Then you have خبر. What is the خبر? The predicate or the news, and that is an اسم. Usually, in the second half of a jumla,
ismiya.
Then we have al-fa'il. What is the fa'il? The actor or the doer, the one who does an action, who does a verb. So a fa'il is going to be somebody or something that does something, right? And it's going to be marfu. It's going to have a dhamma or dhammatayn or the other alamat of rafa. Then we talked about khabar inna. Ism inna is mansoob, but it's actually maftuh, it has a fatha, even though it's not really mansoob. And khabar inna is marfu', ism kana is marfu', we discussed those two. And then the na'ib an al-fa'il. The na'ib fa'il, when it's a maf'ul bihi, when it takes the place of a fa'il, when the fa'il is mahduf, it's hidden. If you didn't understand any of that, don't worry. We're going to hit this, inshallah, until you do. Tayyib, khabar has many types. Al-Mubtada, for now, is just an ism. Even though later on we'll break that rule, but right now it's just one word, and it'll be the beginning word, right? Al-Khabar has many types. And I'm gonna break it up a little bit differently than I did in the last class, so pay attention. One is Al-Khabar Al-Mufrad. Tayyib? What is khabar al-mufrad? When it's just one word, right? If I said al-ilmun nafi'a, tayyib? So what am I saying? The knowledge, al-ilm, that is beneficial. Now, what is your mubtada? Ilm, right? And what is your khabar? Nafi'a. Now, why didn't I say ilmun nafi'un? Why did I say al-ilm? نافع. Yes, عبد الرحمن. Because I know you know.
With the مبتدأ خبر, one is معرفة, one is نافع.
Yes, they have to be switched. Otherwise, it would be صفة موصوف, right? طيب. So خبر مفرد is when it's just a word, one single word, giving us the news about the subject. Everybody good with that?
Yes.
But خبر can be more than one type. Khabar can be an entire jumla. Al-khabar, that is al-jumla. Jumla means sentence. So your khabar can be an entire sentence. And in that, there are going to be two types. Right? Because there's two types of complete jumal, right?
Yes.
Which is? Khabar is of, jumla is of what types? So, khabar, jumla, ismiya, and khabar, jumla, what is it? Fi'liya. And khabar can also be of another type. which is when it's going to be khabar shibh jumla. Shibh jumla, that which is like a jumla but not a complete jumla. And we'll talk about shibh jumla inshallah coming up. But now we're going to have some fun. We're going to look at actual ayat from the Quran, and you guys are going to tell me the meanings, and you're going to make a'rab of them. You're going to actually tell me about the grammar of them. Tell you, I'm going to pick on some of the more advanced students first, inshallah. Tell you, who wants to read the first ayah for me? All right, everybody, go ahead, Dursa. Tell you, that's from the Quran, Surah An-Nisa. Ar-Rijalu Qawamuna ala An-Nisa. Right? Everybody loves this ayah. Wait till you really understand it. Tell you, now, make a'rab of this for me. What do you think? Okay, first thing, what do you think it means? Close meaning, it's okay. You're not making your own translation of the Quran. You're not a mufassir. We're just trying to understand. What does rijal mean?
Men.
Ar-Rijal, yani the men. Qawwamun, what does it mean?
Strong.
Qama, they are, but here the meaning of being in charge or caretakers or responsible for or an authority over. Qawwamun ala nisa, on women. Right? Tell you. But now when we look at this part of the ayah, ala nisa is jar majroor, it's just going to be muta'alliq, but here, what do you think? First thing, we know there's two types of jumal, right? Mm-hmm. Two types of sentences, right, Abdul Mateen? Two types, right? Jumla, ismiya, and jumla, fi'liya. Ismiya begins with an?
Ism.
And fi'liya begins with a? Okay, so then it should be easy for Ramesh to tell me what type of jumla is this?
Ismiya.
Excellent, you got that right. Now, the jumla ismiya must have two things. They're both on this board, so I don't think it should be too difficult.
Yeah, mubtada khabar.
Mubtada khabar. Excellent. So, let's make a'rab here. Where is your mubtada?
Right there.
Right there. I think I was already right here. Al mubtada, is it marfu', mansub, majroor?
Marfu'.
Excellent. So, al mubtada. Marfu'. How did you know it was marfu'?
Dhamma.
Excellent. The dhamma on the lam. So, alamat al-raf'ihi al-dhamma al-dahira. What does that mean? It means, and I want you to write this, because when I give you ayat to make a'rab off, then you're going to have to write like this. Al-mubtada. That means this is the?
Subject.
Everybody with me? Why do I think people are lost here?
Amar. I'm with you.
You with me? Abdurrahman, good, you're with me. Amar. What does it say? Al-mubtada. You can't read it? You gotta change those glasses, bro.
Alright.
Al-mubtada, yani the subject, marfu'. It is in a halat of raf', it's marfu'. Alamatu raf'ihi. How do you know it's marfu'? Bid-dhamma al-dahira. A clear dhamma. Right? Now this is a little advanced, but I'm breaking you guys in because it's not always going to be a clear dhamma or dhammatain or those things to show that a halat, that it's in a condition of being marfu'. But here it is. Tayyib. So we got al-mubtada. What else do we need, Ramis?
Khabar.
We need the khabar. Where's your khabar?
Qawamun.
Qawamun? You sure?
Yeah.
Alright, if you say so, I'm going with it. This is your khabar. Hayyub. What state is it in? What does khabar have to be?
It's supposed to be marfu', but...
By what?
Is it marfu'?
I don't know, you tell me.
Is that
mansub? Is it mansub? This is marfu', as your first instinct told you. طيب. And the علامة of رفع. Here, رفعه is what?
فتح.
Wow. لا.
Wow.
No.
النون.
لا.
What happened to your 7 years of نحو, man?
I don't know what you're talking about.
7 years of نحو is only when you're expecting. طيب, come on, where are my students at? Fatha? You're not my student anymore. علامة رفع الواو. الواو. لأنه مذكر سالم مرفوع بالواو. As we studied in it, we haven't studied in this class, so all you new students, you're off the hook. But in the earlier classes, as we studied جمع مذكر سالم, when you have جمع مذكر سالم, then it's marfu' bil waw. This waw tells you it's marfu'. Like when you see muslimun and then you see muslimin, right? So in that case, if it was marfu', it would be muslimun. If it was majroor, it could be muslimin, right? So the waw is not the only thing that shows raf. The dhamma is not the only thing. I'm only introducing you to this. We're going to hit this hard. But for the more advanced students, you guys should already know this. Especially if you were in my old class. Tayyib. We got that. Now, let's look at the second ayah. And this is from the Quran as well. This first one is the 34th ayah of Surah Al-Nisa. Now, we're doing Rabbukum A'lamu. Surah Al-Isra, the 25th ayah. Tayyib. Who's gonna make I'rab of this for me? Somebody new, brave, able.
Rahman.
Omar, how are your glasses doing? Good?
Yeah.
Can you see now?
Yeah. I can see.
Alright, let's hit the I'rab. Tell me, what do you think?
Jumla
Ismiya. Jumla Ismiya, excellent. That is correct because it begins with Rab, which is an ism. Tayyib, what else? Where's your Mubtada? Osama, you're brave.
The one red is
what? Brave doesn't mean intelligent. Okay, next. Where's your Mubtada? Rabbu is your Mubtada, not Kum. Kum is a Damir. Rab, here is your Mubtada. And it is what? It is? Marfu', excellent. What is the alamat al-raf? Excellent. Ad-dhamma.
Kum damir ghaib.
Ad-dahira. Limada ghaib? Lam tara ad-dhamma? هذا كم هو الضمير ليس في المبتدا يعني في بين الآيات فيها جار مجرور مضاف مضاف إليه ضمائر لكن الرب هنا هو المبتدا طيب والمرفوع بالضمة الظاهرة طيب
I mean كم talking about ضمير غائب here or not just this question is كم here talking about ضمير غائب
no الضمير is there why would it be غائب
the one who's talking about is not here
ربكم نحن طيب لا 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 so when Allah سبحانه وتعالى speaks to us in the Quran we are not غائب يعني it's not متكلم صح but it is speaking to all of us يعني نحن طيب so this is now like if you say ربك هذا متكلم. ربكم الجمعة لنا ليس الغائب. ربهم هو الغائب. صح؟ طيب. Here it's متكلم الضمير المتكلم. ربو the Lord come yours. طيب. أعلموا. Here. Now. We got the مبتدا. I'm pretty sure you guys are gonna guess that this is the
خبر.
طيب. But tell me about the خبر now. الخبر what مرفوع. What is the علامة الرفع؟
ضمة.
Excellent. So these are both what types of khabar? Mufrad. Excellent. So al khabar here is mufrad. And what about here? Al khabar is what type? Mufrad. Again, tayyib. So this is giving you some practice from the Quran itself for one type of khabar. And the reason I'm taking it back to the Quran, I'm finding these ayat, because I want you to start implementing your Arabic to the Quran. I don't really care if you can go to a coffee shop and order coffee, or go to a tailor and order a thawb, you know, but I really do want you to go back to the Quran now and try to yourself find khabar mufrad, khabar jumla ismiya, khabar jumla fi'liya, khabar shabha jumla. So you can start getting practice and understanding the Quran better. Tayyib. And everybody got the meaning, right? Al-Rijal. What did Al-Rijal mean?
Men.
Maslah?
Men.
Qawwamun?
Taking care.
Good caretakers, responsible. Tayyib. Rabbukum? Your Lord? A'lamu. From Alama, right? Knows. A'lamu, yani knows best. Right? أفعلوا. طيب. So here it tells us that Allah knows best. Your Rabb knows best. So this is your subject and this is the news you're getting about your subject. طيب. The next ayah. Arun. You're in glasses, right? You're good?
Salvation first. What's the khair means? Is it, it's better to reconcile.
Excellent. Reconciliation is better. Wonderful. Now you got the meaning. Everybody got that? Abdul Mateen, you got it? Sulh, what does it mean? A sulh, to make sulh, to reconcile,
peace.
To make peace, excellent. Khayrun, what does it mean? Abdul
Malik.
Khayr. Khayr.
Good.
Good, excellent. So you, my negative zero student has even got it. So that means everybody else got it. So to reconcile is better. Meaning instead of fighting and doing all those kinds, it's better to bring peace, to reconcile. Tayyib. So now where is your mubtada? Anyway. Bad count. Go ahead. Your mubtada. Where is your mubtada? This is really easy. You just did this. Sulh. This is your mubtada. Is it marfu, mansub, majrur? مرفوع. What is your علامة? علامة رفعه is الضمة الظاهرة. It's clearly stated, right? Yusuf, where's your خبر?
خير.
Excellent. Woohoo! You're actually learning something. Is it marfu, mansub, majrur?
Marfu.
Marfu. What is your alamat al rafa?
Dhammatayn.
Excellent. Oh, you got a little fancy on me. We just call it a dhamma. Tayyib. Pretty easy so far, right? Everybody good?
Yes.
Everybody good? What's your name, brother? Habib. Habib? Allah, may Allah make you all of our Habib, inshallah. Tayyib, Habib, you good?
Yeah.
All right, Abdul-Mateen, you good? Mashallah. All right. Hamza. Go for it. Excellent. Beautiful pronunciation. Now, go ahead. What does it mean?
Verily Allah over...
Verily Allah...
Over everything is control.
King right. of everything.
Is upon everything Qadir, yani able. Qadir, Allah can overpower, He has the Qudra, He has the ability, He has the control over everything. There is nothing that is out of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's power, or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's Qudra, or His ability to ordain, or to make hukam on. Not going deep in there, but everybody got the basic meaning, right?
Yes.
You good? Harun, you good? Omar, you good? Excellent. Make an Arab of it for me, Harun. Where is it Jumla Ismiya or Fa'liya? You got this, bro. Don't worry. Ismiya, excellent. There's no Fa'l here, so I think you're good. Now, where is your Mubtada?
Allah.
The Ism or the Lafz al-Jalala. When we talk about the word Allah, we call it Lafz al-Jalala. We don't really say Allah is because out of respect. So, this Al-Mubtada is Lafz al-Jalala. Is it marfu', mansub, majroor? What is it? Mansub.
Is it still Mubtada if it's mansub?
I don't know, you tell me, man. This is... I already discussed this last class. Ibrahim knows. We talked about Crips and Bloods and Inna and Kana. Oh, come on, are you gonna act like that, man? Just to let you know, Crips are a gang. They're from like a long time ago. I think it's because they used to carry sticks. People call them cripples. They started the Crips gang. And another black. I know you're kind of a foreigner and all that. So Bloods is another gang. They usually wear red. Crips wear blue. Except some wear green. But anyway, so Bloods are another gang, and they kind of fight. So I know you guys may not know this stuff. I was raised here, so I know this stuff. So tell you. So what's up with the Lafz al-Jalala here? Is it marfu or not?
No,
all right. Mansoob. How many people think it's mansub? Raise your hand. All right. How many think it's marfu? Oh man, Hamza, you're really sure, huh? You got both hands up. All right. How many think marfu? Wow. Man, Musa and Omar. We got Usama now joining in. Habib's on that boat. You guys are right. This is actually marfu. Why? Because it's the Mubtada.
Ism kana?
But it's maftuh. Maftuh meaning it has a fatha on it. But it's actually marfu'. So it's maftuh fi mahal al-rafa. What does that mean? It means it's still the Mubtada. It's still in a condition where it's marfu'. But it has a fatha. Yes, that's true. Because we talked about inna and ikhwatiha. Anna is from the akhwat, the sisters of Inna. And what does Inna, I forgot, did I make Inna's Crips or Bloods? I don't know which one I'm doing.
Crips.
Were they Crips?
Crips.
Oh, come on, that's a pretty big confusion to make here. Alright, so whatever they are, right? Let's call them Surenios and Nortenios, alright? So, whatever Inna was, alright, you got that one?
Yeah, oh, I got that one.
Masla.
Yeah,
where you been hanging out?
I know.
Tayyib, so Anna, when it steps on the scene, it takes over and it makes it maftuh, it puts a fatha. But it's still the mubtada. It's still marfu, but it's got a fatha on it. Tayyib? Now where is your khabar? Alright, so, what did you say? You said? Go ahead. Kulli shay? Who thinks kulli shay?
No.
Ibrahim, you're with that? Alright. Musa, you're with that too? Alright. Anybody with anything different?
What happened?
Qadir.
Where is your khabar?
Qadir.
Qadir?
Qadir.
Qadir? Who's with Qadir? Alright, we're gonna have a ride up in here in a minute. Alright. So, if we said Allah, the love, Dhul Jalala, is the mubtada wa ala kulli shay or kulli shay is your khabar, what does it tell you? Nothing.
I said the whole thing. Ala kulli shay.
Ala kulli shay qadir. Alright. He's right. Qadir. This is your khabar. Your khabar is qadir. So if you said Allahu qadirun, this would be enough. Ala kulli shay. This is this tafsil. This is additional information. It's giving you more, but in essence, the actual sentence is this. Allahu Qadirun. Now we added Anna Allah to show emphasis. And then we added Ala Kulli Shay'in to show tafsir, to explain further on everything. But if we had just said Allahu Qadirun, would that give you some information? Yes.
Yes.
And Allah is modified. Hada Alif Lam. Qadir is Nakira. So this is Mubtada Khabar. So this would be Al Mubtada wal Khabar by itself. Now this is jar, majroor, mutaalliq. Then we'll talk about mutaalliq bil and things. But this is, and then shay'in here is mudaf ilay for the mudaf of kulli. But this is all additional. This is your khabar. Is it marfu or not?
Yes,
marfu.
Marfu. What is the alamat al rafa? Action.
Is inna and anna same ruling?
Yes. Anna and inna are ikhwat. And there's a lot of ikhwat. We're going to cover all of them. You're going to memorize inna and all her ikhwat, kana and all the ikhwat like we did in the other class. So, inshallah, you will know all of them. Tayyib. Now, all of the akhbar, jama for khabar, that we have dealt with right now have been what type? Mufrad. Right? I'm glad we recorded this. Tell you. With my color theme. Tell you. You know, we wonder sometimes, how did the Arab read the Quran when they had no nuqut, like they had no dots, and they had no harakat, they had no fatha, dhamma, kasra, right? I mean, have you ever looked at the original Quran, like the one from Uthman Radiyallahu Anhu's time that they still have? I can't read it, you know? I mean, maybe if I know the surah, I can kind of, you know, just read it from memory and pretend like I'm reading it, but it's hard to read. But I'm going to do something crazy right now, right? I'm going to make you guys put the harakat. And you beginning students of Arabic will be able to do it. I'll put the ones here. But the end, you're gonna put it, and then you're gonna tell me why you put what you put. Faddalu, you like pain. Come on down.
Wait, right?
Yeah, I actually get up out of the seat, move around. Shake it up a little bit. There you go, brother. Fadbar. Excellent. Excellent. Now, why? Just so you can go on video and be profane right now.
Allah. Because inna.
Inna. Excellent.
So it takes over.
And this is your mubtada?
Yes.
Excellent. Al mubtada. Marfu. Hayya.
Ghafur Rahim. This is your khabar.
This is your khabar. Which one?
Both. both.
Or is it badal?
Badal.
This is khabar and this is khabar. They're both khabar. Right. Excellent. Okay. Sit down. Good job, mashallah. Tell you. So here, this is your mubtada. It is marfu', but مفتوح لأنه اسم إن تغير.
It's because of the فتح.
It's because the فتح is there, which means it's مفتوح بالفتحة. Why? Because it's the اسم of إن. Right? But it is في محل الرفع, in the place of being مرفوع, right? Because it's the مبتدا. Now this is your خبر. And this is also your خبر. Although for your advanced students, you could make an argument that this is بدل, but that's all different issue. خبر مرفوع. Where is your علامات الرفع؟
والله كده.
طيب. And this is your خبر ثاني. خبر ثاني. Also, same thing. I just point. What does it mean, Dursa?
Verily, Allah is forgiving and
extremely forgiving. Extremely. Let's take a little linguistic step back. What is the root word here? Ghafara. And what is the root word here? Rahama. Tell you. If somebody was to show, was to forgive somebody, right? Well, how would you make this ism fa'il? Ghafir. Allah is ghafir al-dunub, right? And if somebody shows mercy, rahim. But here, this is ism mubalagha. Ghafoor, rahim. To show that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is extremely forgiving and extremely merciful. Tell you.
What type of jumla is
this? This was jumla of mufrad. Yes, it was two of them, but they were still mufrad. Shibih jumla, we'll discuss inshallah, it will either be jar majroor or mudaf mudaf ilay. Tayyib. These are all from the Quran. So this is now from Surah Al-Baqarah, the 255th ayah. You all should know already. Tayyib, what is the meaning here? First off, easy. Abdul Qadir, go for it. Allah. Easy. What does it mean? Allah. There is no ilah except for Him. Right? Everybody got the meaning? Abdul Mateen, you got the meaning? Allah, la ilaha. There is no ilah. There is none worthy of worship. Ilah means something that's worthy that has worship.
Except Him.
Except Him. Or He, meaning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we're confirming. Right? You got the meaning here? Everybody good? You good? 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 Alright. Now, where is it, Umar? Is it jumla ismiya or fi'liya? Yusuf? Ismiya?
No.
Oh, you were good. Ismiya. Alright. So what does it begin with? What is your mubtada?
Allah.
Mubtada or your subject is the love of Jalala. The word Allah. Is it marfu?
No.
How do you know?
Because of the Dhamma.
Excellent. علامة رفعه الضمة الظاهرة. Excellent. Who said that? Who said that? Maslah? Good job. Alright. Hey you, where is your khabar? The Jumla Ismiya must have what?
Khabar.
Where's your khabar?
Ilaha.
Ilaha? Ilahu?
No.
Alright. Let's see some hands. Who says Ilah is the khabar?
Ilah.
Alright. We got Amar, Usama, Amar, Habib. I don't know your name. What's your name? Huh? Khalid? MashaAllah. I just wanted to know who to embarrass later. Okay, so what was the other opinion here amongst the ulama and nahu here? What is the other opinion? Huwa? Did somebody say huwa? No? Illa? No. No other opinions?
All of it.
This whole thing is the khabar? Is that what you're saying? You're right! This whole thing is the khabar. Now, is it marfu? It is in a state of raf. But because it's not one word, it's not mufrad, you don't have to have a dhamma on it, right? But what type of khabar is this? Ayyab? Jumla... Ismiya? You sure? Who thinks Jumla Ismiya? You are right! You didn't win anything, don't get too happy. Tayyib, except for the knowledge. Yeah. Jumla Ismiya. Al-Khabar, now we're looking at a different type. Now it's no longer just mufrad. Now a whole sentence. Allah, the love of Al-Jalala, this is what the subject is we're talking about. And what are we telling you about it? We're not just telling you it's Ghafoor, or Rahim, or A'lamu. We're telling you, La ilaha illa huwa. That's the news that is being conveyed in this ayah from Surah Al-Baqarah, or just part of this ayah. Tayyib, so it's khabar, al-jumla, ismiya, excellent.
Yes. Mufrad means what exactly?
Mufrad means single, like you used to be. And jama'ah means plural, like you are. Tayyib. Everybody got this?
Oh yeah.
Good, I'm glad you did. What's up? From Surah Al-Ra'd, the 26th ayah. Who wants to take a shot?
Jumla Ismiya.
Jumla ismiya, excellent. What should I put as the A'rab here? A Dhamma?
Yeah,
that's right. Good job. This is your Al-Mubtada. It is? Marfu. Excellent. Excellent. Al-Amat al-Raf'ihi. Al-Dhamma. Al-Zahira. Excellent. Now, where's your khabar? Yabsut? All of it?
Jumla fi'liya khabar.
Jumla fi'liya khabar. Ooh, taking it wild there. Jumla ismiya. Excellent. Where's your khabar? You tell me. That's what I hear. I'm just writing what I hear. Tell you. So we agreed that this whole thing is jumla ismiya.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Alright?
So it can't be there's more than like khabar, like fi'l or fa'l or anything.
Alright. So we agreed also that the lafdhul jalala is your mubtada. But we also know in jumla ismiya you have to have what, Yusuf?
Fi'l.
You have to have fi'l?
Jumla ismiya had to have khabar.
Khabar. So we don't have a khabar. Where is your khabar? Is it? Just this? Is it this? Is it this? Is it this? No, you tell me. You're just guessing?
Yabsutu is action. Allah opens his hands.
Yabsutu is an action. It's a fi'l, right? What does it mean?
To stretch his hand.
To stretch or to extend, right? A rizq is sustenance. لِمَنْ يَشَاءَ to whoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wills. Everybody got the meaning? Allah extends or opens up or gives rizq, sustenance, provisions to whoever He wills. Okay? So we got the fact that this is a jumla ismiya, we got the mubtada. Where is your khabar? Abdurrahim thinks it's all of it, but I think Hammam has some khilaf bain al ulama. Hammam, what do you think? So this fi'l is your khabar?
I was thinking about risk.
I think about risk all the time. Where do I go to work?
It can't be risk because if you say Allah risk.
No.
There's no khabar. Excellent. And also, mansub. And there's no inna or anything to make it mansub.
But we have only mansub, yabsutu and yasha.
Sayyid, where's your khabar? This fi'l is your khabar? Khabar has to be ism. Right?
No, the whole thing.
Also. So the whole thing, that is the correct answer. Abdurrahim was right. I don't know if you learned that from my class or you're just a quick learner, mashallah. Either way, your khabar is al-jumla al-fi'liya. This whole thing is a jumla fi'liya. And this whole jumla fi'liya is your khabar. This is your fi'l. Your fa'il is here. And the ya, it points towards your fa'il. Rizq is what?
Sustenance.
Maf'ul bihi. In grammar. I know it's sustenance. I already told you, Musa. Right? Jar, majroor, other fi'l. But this is your whole khabar. So now we have covered khabar as a mufrad, khabar as a jumla ismiya, khabar as a jumla fi'liya, right? I wonder what's left.
Can you say that whole sentence is jumla fi'liya?
From yabsutu is all jumla fi'liya. There's your fi'l, there's your fa'il, the ya points towards it. So this whole jumla fi'liya is your khabar.
But it's still ismiya with Allah.
Ismiya, this whole jumla is ismiya. But the khabar itself is the jumla by itself. Yeah. Yes.
Could yabsutu rizqa by itself be the khabar jumla fi'liya?
Could be.
Could be, right?
Yeah. Because you have your fi'l, your fa'il is there and maf'ul bihi, so that's fine.
Right.
I mean, yeah, if you take it that way, even yafsutu would be enough.
Right?
Huh? It is enough for information. Tell you. I'm trying to get too advanced here, bro. Take it easy. Now, this is a very, very easy, 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 easy one. Who has read this before?
Everyone.
Every day. Part of Surah Al-Fatiha. Every time we read, make salah, you better be reading it. Say you. Alhamdu lillahi.
All praise to Allah.
Excellent. All praise exclusively due to Allah. We did tafsir of it already. Great. Now, everybody know the meaning, right? Abdul Mateen, you know the meaning? Alhamdu lillahi. You know the meaning or no? Alhamdulillah, mashallah, you said already. Alhamdulillah. Tell you. Now, how can we make a'rab of it? Is it jumla fi'liya, Ibrahim, or jumla ismiya?
Ismiya.
Ismiya, excellent, you are correct. And that means you must have two things. What are the dosa? I knew you knew that. That was an easy one.
Give him the hard one.
I'm saving the hard one for him later so he doesn't get upset. Throw some easy ones at him first.
Build up the confidence.
Al-Muftada is Alhamdu. Tayyip, everybody good with that?
Yes.
Is it Marfu', Mansub, Majroor? Marfu'. What is the Alamatul Raf'i?
Dhamma.
Excellent, Yusuf. Is Al-Dhamma. What type of Dhamma, Yusuf? Is it? Al-Dahira. Or is it Hat? Is it Mahdoof? Is it hidden? No? Say it. Excellent. Where's your khabar?
Allah.
Allah.
Allah?
Lillah.
Lillah. So this is actually Lam. Li. Allah. Tayyip. When you put them together, you drop the alif lam, so it becomes lillahi, like this. Tayyip. So this is actually jar majroor. The lafzul jalala is majroor because the lam. What type of lam is it for you guys who are in my dars, tarjumatu i'tiqad and fatiha and nukhba and everything else that I've taught and began with alhamdulillah and drilled this into you guys so many times? Darsa. Ikhtisas. It's not milkiya. Yani exclusively lillahi subhanahu wa ta'ala. Tayyip. So is that your khabar?
Yes.
Who agrees?
Yes, it is.
Yes. Oh man, Abdul Rahman agrees now. It's gotta be.
Yeah.
Everybody agree on that?
Yeah.
Any khilaf bain al ulama here?
No.
Hatum islam marfu. The lam. Excellent. So what type of khabar is it then? Huh? Shibh jumla. Excellent. Did you know that or is just because we're going down the chart? It's khabar shibh. Al-jumla. Shibh jumla. It's like a jumla, but it's not complete. Right? If you say lillahi by itself, or an abihi, or ala kursi, it's like a sentence, but it's not a complete meaning. So in Arabic we call it shibh jumla, يعني it's like a jumla. طيب? And that can be the khabar. Because if you put it together, does it make sense?
Yes.
Does it bring you some news? Does it enrich your knowledge? Yes. So it is a complete sentence. It's a jumla ismiya. Your mubtada is alhamdu. And the lam, al-ikhtisas, and the lafzul jalala, together, make up your khabar with the shibh jumla.
Yeah, that's 10.
So now we have covered all types of khabar. Khabar mufrad, khabar al-jumla ismiya, khabar al-jumla fi'liya, khabar shibh jumla. And that is the four types of akhbar that you have in Arabic language. Tayyip. We've given examples from the Quran for each one of them. Now, your homework, inshallah, I want you to make for me 50 sentences. Yes, I said that right, 50. And I'm giving you a whole week. You know, when I was studying, and this is a witness from my teacher, Sheikh Ubaid al-Rahman, if you ever watches this video, he used to give us crazy homework. It would be like, find 50 examples of Jumla Ismiya in the Quran by tomorrow morning. And then we would be up till Fajr trying to find all these examples in the Quran, or it would be like, write 100 sentences by tomorrow morning and make Arab of them. Or he would give us like ayat and surah, a whole surah, make Arab of it without looking in the books of Arab. And he would make us do that by the next morning. I'm giving you a whole week. And your easy homework is make 50 sentences. They can be either ismiya or fi'liya. No shibha jumla. So if you begin it with a fi'l, like daraba, uthmanu, zaydan. Where is zaydan for me to be? Then that's going to be a jumla fi'liya. If you put uthman, jameelun, then that's going to be the truth. And it's going to be a jumla ismiya because it starts with an ism. So you're going to go make 50 sentences and then you're going to write with it. Whether it's jumla ismiya or jumla fi'liya, you're going to write with it. Where is the mubtada? Where is the khabar? Where is the fi'l? Where is the fa'il? Got it?
Yes.
Everybody got it? And on top of that, inshallah, you have your next vocabulary words. If you need help with that, you can come earlier. Brother Abdul Rahman is here to help. And you can come on Thursday. You're going to be up Thursday? After Isha as well, inshallah, our co-teachers will be helping out, inshallah. جزاكم الله خيرا.
إلا تنصروه فقد نصره الله.